for our audience, the takeaway of today is really how to protect ourselves. And you mentioned a little bit earlier, and would you like to tell us more about the protections from different channels, different levels, how as an individual, myself, yourself, protect ourselves from all the phishing attacks and extortion attempts?
Yeah, absolutely. So the key in any of this is education, right? The place that we start is education. Read about what is cybersecurity on your own. Start with the mobile. It's my favorite thing, and it's where all the hacking starts. You know, you saw the previous slide, the 30%, 39% attacks are sent through the mobile. So don't trust people you don't know. Just like in life, you know, you don't know somebody, don't trust them. Don't trust that SMS. Even though you've got lots of WhatsApp messages and all these other things, or even other applications that there are chats, it's the same thing as SMS. Don't click those links. So, absolutely. Also on the mobile, keep an idea of the permissions on those apps. You know, if a recipe app requires your camera, like, or some recognition, or your location, don't accept what you don't agree with. That's one thing I would suggest also.
Because we normally just by default agree, agree.
Because
that's a danger.
It's like 20 pages of, you know, nobody has time to read that. But if you really want to protect yourself, you've got to read that.
Okay, just be more aware about it. Be more cautious about it.
Absolutely. And on the mobile, you've got the email too. I mean, email could be on your desktop or at your work. But if you're like me, you're in the car, you're checking email in there, you got to be careful. Like, you look at an email and it's a link you don't want to hit, but your finger accidentally touches it. It still hit, even you didn't want to. So just be careful. When it comes to the laptop, I mean, the laptop and the desktop, you know, whether it's Microsoft or whether it's Linux, there's a lot of built-in protection. But there's all, you should definitely look at third-party vendors. Look at other vendors out there, because they work in a different model. They've got specific teams that only look for threats. So go out there, you know, spend your $50 a year or $100 a year and protect your whole family's devices. Because the laptop is where everything is. You know, you've got all your photos on there, you do all your banking and such. So
Important personal data.
Sometimes I'm on calls with people in different countries, and you know what they'll say? Can we move the call to the next hour? Because my son has to use my work laptop for school. Yeah, sure, of course.
So we just family asset.
It's family asset. Yeah, family assets are being passed around. So just be very careful about the laptops and the desktops. Plus, cover your webcams. So, you know, on the webcam there, you can buy a little thing and stick over top or a piece of tape. There's no reason to have your webcam open if you're not using it. So even our company actually gives us little things, little sliders. So just look around for them. Okay. Cover your webcam for privacy.
That's extremely important advice, because we are working from home, learning from home so often nowadays. And sometimes you just forget about switching off your camera. So that's a very good advice.
Absolutely. So only install software from safe sources. You know, you see some really cool Photoshop type thing, you know, if you don't know where that is from, don't install it. If it's not from an app store, because guaranteed there's something in there you don't want. So just always be very careful. And the last thing, so we talked a little bit about Wi-Fi, right? You got Wi-Fi at your house, and you got Wi-Fi at the mall, you got Wi-Fi at the coffee shop. You just got to be really careful about those things. And there's no way you're going to know unless your phone is protected with a security software that knows that's not a Starbucks ID. So the Wi-Fi at home, make sure your software is current. So, you know, you got your little router at home. It's generally updated, but there are some routers. There was an article just about 2 or 3 months ago. There were hundreds of a certain brand of routers at home that could not be patched. They literally could not be patched. There was a vulnerability in the firmware. Couldn't update it. Also set the passwords. I think most people set passwords,
most people do that.
But some people don't. Unfortunately, there's a few people who don't. But you set the password, that's actually good. If your SSID is public, people can see it. Hackers can sniff the packets. If they want to, they can break that. They have to really want to, though. There's a way to prevent it from showing. You can hide your SSID. Makes it harder at the home. You know, somebody in the house says, I can't connect to the internet. Well, they can't see it, so you have to do some extra work. But there is a way to protect your Wi-Fi by doing that, by hiding your SSID. A little bit advanced, but it's just another way to do it.
So what I hear is really one very important word, be cautious.
Be cautious on everything you do.
Yes.
Every digital place you touch, every digital record, every interaction, your banking, your government type work, your schooling, just be very cognizant of what could happen.
Great, that's really enlightening. I have so much learning today. Thank you, James. Thank you so much.
Sure, great to be here.
Yeah.
Thanks.
Indeed, in today's very connected world, it's extremely important to know all the knowledge about cybersecurity, get ourselves protected, and it's extremely important to work in a defended environment for the benefit of ourselves and others. So I hope you have learned something from our talk today. I'm Fei from Singapore Management University, and thank you for joining us. We look forward to meet you again in next session.